Hello everyone, today we'll be discussing problem C from Codeforces Round 539. For detailed problem statement, follow the link in the description. What the problem wants to say is, you are given an array. So say you are given an array of size 5 and the array elements are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, now what you need to tell is the number of segments or subarrays in this array which will have the XOR sum of the left half equal to the XOR sum of the right half. What do they mean by that is, say you chose a segment having elements A, B, C, D. Okay, these are the four contiguous elements which were there in your segment. So for this to be a possible answer, what it should have is A's or B should be equal to C's or D, which means the XOR sum of this left half should be equal to the XOR sum of the right half. Now you need to tell how many such segments are present in this array. So this is what they want you to tell. Now if we look into this, what they are trying to say is you need to find the number of segments such that they have the first half XOR sum equal to the second half. Now if you have the number of elements which is odd, so instead of 4 elements, if you would have 5 elements, then you can't do this. Okay, so your segments will always be of even length, because if there is an odd length, you cannot divide it into 2 equal halves. So that is one thing, that you will always have segments of equal length, sorry, even length, which will give two equal halves. Now, what do we actually mean by this? A's or B is equal to C's or D. This is basically equal to A's or B's or C's or D equal to 0. How? Because we know that X XOR X is equal to 0, right? And now this is equal to this, so I can write this both things as X, right? Then if I do XOR of these two things, then X XOR X is equal to 0, so A XOR B XORed with this C XOR D will be equal to 0. So the problem reduces to finding the number of segments which have the XOR sum as 0. Okay, and the length of this segment should be even. Now how to calculate this? Okay, you can have a prefix XOR. Okay, if you calculate the prefix XOR array, then what, how can you find the XOR sum of L to R? It is very simple, right? You take P XOR of R and you XOR it with P XOR of L minus 1. That is basically, if you have the XOR of A, B, C, D, E, right, and you want the XOR of C, D, E, so what you basically do is you take the XOR sum of A, B, C, D, E and you then XOR it with A, B. So you will be basically left with C, D, E, because A XOR A will cancel and B XOR B will cancel and you will be left with C, D, E. That is a XOR property. Okay, now what we want this thing to be? We want this thing to be equal to 0, right? If we want this thing to be equal to 0, which in we write it, this also means we want P XOR of R should be equal to P XOR of L minus 1. Why? Using the same property again. If we want A XOR B to be equal to 0, then what we basically want is P XOR R should be equal to prefix XOR L minus 1. Now the problem reduces down to, if you have a particular prefix XOR, then you need to find how many previous prefix XORs are there which are having the same value. Okay, but then again, this would have worked if the length wouldn't have been any constraint, but here we need to have the length which is only even. So how to tackle that? let us look into this. So the elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the indexing, if it is 0 indexing, it will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So now, if you are at stage 3, basically you are at index 3. So your prefix zor at this point of time is 1 zor, 2 zor, 3 zor, 4. Okay. Now, what are the possible values of L? I am saying this is R. In this zor sum L, R. So this position is R. So 3 is your R. What can be the possible values of L? You can take 2 as L. Why? Because the number of elements in 2, 3 is 2. Right? Now if you take L as 1, 1, 3, how many elements are there in 1, 3? 3 elements. So you cannot take this one. Now again, if you consider this 0th index as L, you have 4 elements. Then again you can take this. Okay? So the possible values of L, if this is R and this is L, so the possible values are 2 and 0. So what are the possible values of L minus 1? So the possible values of L minus 1 will be just one less than that. Okay. So now when we were at an odd position, 3 index, index 3 is an odd position, right? So then the possible values of L were at even positions. So the possible values for L minus 1 will be at odd position only. So for even, it will be at even position, and for odd, it will be at odd position. How? We just looked into an odd position, right? For odd position, the possible L values were 2 and 0. So L minus 1 will be 1. Similarly, if you are at an even position, say like 4, then possible values of L will be 3 and 1. So possible values of L minus 1 will be 2 and 0. So if you are at an even index, so possible values of L minus 1 should be from an even index only. So what this tells us is, if you are at a position, say like you have the zor sum to be equal to 25 and you are at an even index, okay? So if you are at an even index and your zor sum is 25, then you need to find out previously how many even indices have given the zor sum 25. Because if you find that how many previous even indices have given you 25, then basically what that means is you have P zor L minus 1 equal to P zor R, plus as you are taking only even indices, this also takes care of this length factor, that the length is going to be always even. So when you are at an odd position, you will be looking for that particular sum which are given by the odd indices only, and you will be looking for even indices sum when you are at an even position. So you can see the states of DP now. So what are the states of the DP we can think of? That now the states of the DP will be, one is going to be the P zor thing, okay? Because when you are at a particular state, you want the same zor sum to be have appeared before, otherwise it doesn't make any sense, because it won't make the zor sum of the whole segment to be zero. Plus if you want the length to be same, if you are at an even index, you want the sum to be coming from an even index only. So let me call this position. So if this is 0, that means that this zor sum was given by an even index. So that particular zor sum was having R as an even index, right? So what are the possible values of this position? 2 only, right? Even and odd. So we can write 0 or 1. What are the possible values of this zor sum? It can maximum go up to the maximum value, right? So it is maximum value of this, if this is array A, so maximum value of A of, okay? Code this. you simply run a loop for I in range 0 to n. Okay, so it is basically running a loop from I equal to 0, I less than equals to n minus 1. So I will be taking all the elements one by one. Okay, so prefix zor is going to be prefix zor zored with a of I. So what is the previous value of prefix zor that we are going to have? So prefix zor is going to be initialized to 0. So I have this prefix zor with me right now. So I need to find the number of segments where r is the ending thing. So what will I be looking for? If my answer is initially 0, so I want my answer to be updated with dp of prefix zor, because I am looking for this zor. If this sum has occurred before, then it is a valid choice. But then again, it should have occurred only at I modulo 2th positions. So if I am at even position, this prefix sum should have been provided by an even position only. Okay, so this thing will take care of that. Now we will update the value of dp p zor I modulo 2 by 1 plus equals to 1. So this thing is initially initialized with zeros. Okay, so finally we will return the answer. Okay, now few base conditions need to be checked here. What are going to be the values for dp of 0 comma 0 and dp of 0 comma 1? So let us look into few examples. Okay, so why are we having this thing here? Because here the prefix zor only, the zor only is 0. Okay, so if we see a zor sum directly to be 0, it needs to be handled differently, right? Because in that case, it itself can contribute to the answer, right? So let us suppose we have an array of only one length and only the element present is, say, like 0. So 0th index, only one element, it was 0. Okay, so now when you reach here, the zor sum is going to be 0. Okay, so dp of p zor I modulo 2, it is 0 comma 0. So I will be looking at dp 0 comma 0 for this position. So what that should return? That should obviously return 0. Why? Because it is having an odd length and we cannot form an answer which is having an odd length. We always need an even length. Now let us look into an even length thing. So if we have two elements and say that they are 1 and 1. So when I reach here, the zor sum is going to be 0 again. Okay, so the thing that I will be looking here for will be dp of 0 comma 1, and here I was looking for dp of 0 comma 0. Okay, so this 0 comma 1, what this thing should be? This thing should be 1, because if we don't take this thing 1, then we'll be losing the count of this, because this segment 1 comma 1 in itself is a segment which is having 0 sum. So the base case of 0 comma 1 should be 1. Okay, this is a crucial part that many people miss, and because of that they are not able to form the perfect dp. So 0 comma 1 in this case should be equal to 1, because otherwise you will be missing the counts of this. Okay, so when you initialize your array, make sure that you set dp of 0 comma 1 to be 1. Okay, so this was all for this problem. For implementation, you can follow the link in the description. Happy coding.